Jazz is the ability to improvise. For me, it's you know, it's the way of life. It's the way. It's in everything. It's in what we do. It's in how we react to certain things, and you know, to what life gives us. I do. It was my father liked to play a lot of jazz records on Sundays, and he liked to play Abdul Ibrahim Nizna Blue. That was his favorite album. So that was my introduction into this improvised music. At a young age, I mean, I noticed that I was very, I could, how can I say it? How can I say it other than the most obvious way? I could sing very well. And I noticed that I could pay very close attention to the way I was singing and how I was delivering whatever I was singing, you know. And in later years, I discovered that, okay, this is an instrument, and an instrument which I can use to express how I'm feeling, you know. And obviously because of how good I was at it, or however good I thought I was at the time, you know, I could use it as the instrument of choice. Well, I mean, everyone is an individual in the voice, and that is what speaks to, that also speaks to the harmony. Every texture is synonymous to the person, you know. You only have your voice because you are who you are. So when it comes to singing, it has to do a lot with you, but also a lot to do with your influence and where you learned how to sing. I believe I sing the way I do because I started out in a church, you know. I see that whole, the sound-based music, where vocal music is not only a standalone, it's not something, it's not a shine, a spotlight type of, it's a sound which, together with other sounds, makes one cohesive, beautiful sound, you know. And that speaks to harmony, and it speaks to that communal ideology of you cannot exist alone, you cannot be beautiful without, you know, without illuminating those around you and helping, and those around you helping you illuminate even more, you know, to become lumen. Sing the way I do because it moves away from that an individualistic kind of, yes, we are individuals, but that how to be communal and to find your voice as an individual, you know, but still in that communal context, you know what I mean? So yeah, I think that's what church did. And like Ella, I mean, she has the narrative of where the blues and where that community came from, where all her aspects and what she was listening to, where that came through. But you can hear, man, it's more than her, you know, how you listen to the piano and react to that, how you listen to the guitar and react to that, how you listen to the saxophone and react to that. Jazz is a very communal, a communal way of improvising, a communal way of making music. So even through the singing, you find that the voice is more of a partner than it is a stand-alone kind of receive all the information alone, you know. I'm forced to hear, I'm forced to listen, I'm forced to be quiet, I'm forced to be loud in some spaces. So that speaks to the church and the community. Because with range, it comes a variety of instruments. You know, they're always saying, with freedom, it's not what you can do, but what you need to do in that moment. That is my definition of freedom. So with vocals, it's not how high I can sing or how low I can sing, but what needs to be sung at that particular moment. What needs to register? What needs to be the reaction in order to get the best solution or the best, reaction from that, you know, from that solution. So I think that's what texture is, in actual fact, is the ability to hear what needs to happen at this moment, you know. And that also speaks to improvisation, you know, that is the best type of improvisation, to be able to retrospect, and in that moment retrospectively see things and react like instantaneously. So yeah, that for me is way more important, but more vital to music, to the sound, than any type of technicality or any type of creativity, you know, because the context is just the context in itself will show you what needs to be done, will show you how you need to flow in it, how, you know, the type of sound you want to create, if you need to be coarse, if you need to belt, if you need to be quiet, you know. So those are the nuances that vocals creates. I'm always listening to traditional African music, you know, and always had a fascination with music like Sabo Sangom, you know, and how they use that music to articulate what they need to do. It moves away from technicalities and from this is how your sound is, but really into circumstance, that this is what I need to create, so this sound is what needs to be produced in order to have this effect, or not even to have this effect, but to be able to channel this type of energy, you know. So with regards to the singing, yes, I mean a lot of right now it's very much individualistic, but we are moving into an era where people are starting to notice that you cannot live without others. We need to coexist, even inside the music, even within the music, even with on the bandstand, you know. I feel like the best types of the best concerts or the best gigs happen when there's an energy on the stage where everyone is so cohesive, everyone is just so, you know, has even with parallel ideologies, they come together and formulate this one amazing sound, you know. So it's that's where we're moving towards right now, and that's the redefinition of what we're actually trying to accomplish right now. And it's been done, like I say, with referencing music, Tsabo Sangoma, Tsabo Busimhlongo, you know, and Tate Philip Taban, you know, just that deep understanding of how to remain an individual, but to remember that the community and things around you play as an important aspect to what you're trying to do, and to be able to move from there. Well, jazz fundamentally, I think, teaches you how to improvise. So in order to be able to improvise, you need to know that you have options. So it's moving away from that stagnant outlook of saying these are the options and this is the option and this is what needs, this is the only thing that can be done, this is the right thing. Jazz moves away from that and says, in every situation, these are the options that you have. It opens the mind, it opens the ears up to different perceptions, to say you can look at it this way or you can look at it that way. So in terms of learning music, you wouldn't want to, it's not per se choosing jazz as the right type of music or right genre for kids to listen to, because that's not what jazz is. But it's trying to open up the child's mind to say there is beauty in so many other types of musical interpretations or musical genres in the world, you know. So when you have a jazz approach to teaching your child, you are essentially giving your child options to choose from in life, to say that not only hip hop exists, but classical music exists. Mbaqanga exists. Kwaito exists. R&B exists. Pop, indie. Because it's the opening. It's the introduction of opening the ear, opening yourself up to a lot of other options. What we have in the Methodist prayer is called the catechism, I think in English, but it's Katika Seva, that's how I know it. Kaka Sizulu. So I don't know it, it's really long, it's a long prayer. I never crammed it in my life. I used to read it from, but the melody always speaks back to me, and just I think it obviously does, it has a lot to do with the way I create melodies and where I see the inflections and where I see the articulations, But a little demo would be, I don't know if you know that, I'd have to just sing the melody. Na 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 na, oh I, la le, oh I. Something like that, then da 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 da. Etc., etc., etc. But I think that the inflections and the textures and how this music was communicated to me as a kid, and how the harmonies, how the intricate harmonies communicated itself and how it created this bed of melody and this beautiful sound. I think it had a lot to do with how I create music right now and how I see music, how I see the voice, how I see the different harmonies, how I see parallel ideas coming into creating one really incredible sound.